Thank you. Okay, I would like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to attend this conference and to speak here and present some of my results. I apologize first because I changed the topic of my talk. Actually, I look at the list of participants and I found that many PhDs and postdocs were present in Kolkata conference who are also here. So I have already talked about frozen quantum correlations there. So I do not want to bore for half an hour all these students and postdocs. So I changed the topic and I'll be talking about some of our activities regarding this monogamy of quantum correlation. Already in the morning, we have heard about monogamy of quantum correlation and its application. So that kind of already introduction has been given. The work will be based on one of the book chapter that we written on this general lectures on general quantum correlation and the application, this book published in Springer, and the, also the paper in archive. And this is monogamy. The people who are involved in this project is Shoptoshi, who is in the audience, Tomogno and Ashutosh. Tomogno now in Gdansk and Ujjal. I also request Shoptoshi is giving a poster on deterministic quantum dense coding networks. So please go there. This is another kind of classical information transmission proposals that we have given recently in a network scenario. It was known for two-party already and probably interesting also in experiments, especially in, by using photons. The people who are involved in this lecture notes are Himadri, Amit, and Devraj. They were postdoc. Himadri now in Vienna, Amit in Swansea, and Devraj is in Warsaw. So, okay, so now the moral is outline of my talk. So first I will discuss what is monogamy. And then I will talk about monogamy of quantum correlations, mainly how to quantify monogamy of quantum correlation. And then I will present our results, activation of non-monogamous states. I will introduce the concept. And then I will also talk about that. And finally, I will conclude. So what is monogamy? Okay, so this is the probably the picture in the society. This was drawn by Amit and is also in the in our paper in that book chapter. Okay, so the question that we ask specifically is the following. Is sharing quantum correlation between several parties restricted or not? So to define or to introduce monogamy, we need at least three parties. So let's say A, B, and C, which share a state row A, B, C. So for time being, these are my Alice, Bob, and Charlie. So who watch Bollywood movie, they know these are the old characters in my time, not probably in your time. And what monogamy states that if Alice and Bob is maximally quantum correlated, then A and C cannot have any quantum correlations between them. So this was probably first noticed in the Eckhart's PRL paper on quantum cryptography and by also by Bennett and others. So here one should stress that in case of classical correlation, such monogamy relation doesn't hold. So if A and B is highly classically correlated, at the same time A and C can also have a high classical correlation. So the quantum correlation, as I said, that the extremum situation is when A and B is maximally quantum correlated, then at the same time A and C cannot have any quantum correlation. But there can be a trade-off, right? This A and B can be highly quantum correlated, then A and C will be the have the weak quantum correlation. And there is a trade-off between the amount of quantum correlation shared between A, B, and A, C in a three-party scenario. So this is the monogamy. Now here, before I quantify monogamy relation, let's tell that or stress here that this is the key ingredient in the security of quantum cryptography. Because suppose sender and receiver wants to share the identical key. If they can confirm that they are highly or close to the maximum quantum correlation they have, then they are sure there is no eavesdropper who is at all correlated with them or they have any information about the key. Okay, so now we come to the quantification, that is monogamy of quantum correlation, how to quantify. Okay, so as I said, there are at least three parties. I defined first for three parties. It can be easily generalized for n parties. So A and B, suppose there is a state rho ABC, and I consider quantum correlation between A and B according to some measure Q, which Q rho AB I denoted now onwards by QAB. Now I also considered the quantum correlation between Q and QAC, that A and C. That means tracing out B part, I calculate the quantum correlations between A and C, and I sum them. Now I want to see whether sum is bounded above by the quantum correlation which A and B, ABC share in the bipartition A is to BC. So if Q is monogamous, then Q should satisfy this relation. And this was introduced in 2000 by Kaufman, Kundu, Uters. So here we also can define for our a bit more convenient way, we can say that there is a delta Q which is like that, which is QABC minus QAB minus QAC. If Q is monogamous, that means if delta Q is non-negative for all states, then that implies that Q is monogamous. If delta Q is negative for certain states, then that will imply that Q is non-monogamous. Now, as I said, it can be easily generalized to a n plus one party scenario. So here is A and there are many n's, and you want to write the monogamy relations for n party. Now, this is important also in many different contexts, because you see that we are able to write some equation where we want to characterize multipartite quantum correlation by using bipartite one. And we know that there are certain measures, for example, entanglement of formation, concurrence, negativity, logarithmic negativity, they are all computable quantum correlation measure. So in this scenario, at least we will be able to calculate. So we can use, for example, in many body systems. And in this talk, I will be mainly considering the logarithmic negativity or negativity, which is defined like that, where negativity, I mean, computationally, it is the absolute sum of all the negative eigenvalues of the partial transpose state. Now, it was shown in 2007 that squared negativity follow the monogamy relation. As we know from Kaufman Kunduta's paper and also by Osborne and Frank Verstedt, that concurrent square also follow the monogamy relation. However, they themselves violate the monogamy relation. So squared negativity, squared concurrence are monogamous, but they, if you don't take square, they are not, they do not satisfy monogamy relation. Now, if you look at that way, then none of the entanglement measure, not the other quantum correlation measures independent of entanglement follow monogamy relation. So for example, if you consider quantum discord, which is defined probably in this community, it's not need to the definition, it is a definition, it is defined in the difference between total and classical correlation. It is important to explain phenomena where entanglement is absent. And so you can show that quantum discord doesn't follow, or quantum discord violates monogamy relation. And this can be easily seen if you consider these two families of three qubit states. One is a generalized GHZ state, another is a generalized W state. And you can show that the generalized GHZ states are all satisfy monogamy relation, while generalized W states violate monogamy relation. You can study more three qubit scenario, and here we more or less tabulated. So if you know that there are two inequivalent SLOCC inequivalent classes in three qubit, one is a GHZ class, another is a W class. And we know that if you take the GHZ class, then 90% states satisfy monogamy relation, 10% do not. And all the states from the W class violate monogamy relation. And this was shown in 2012, Prabhu is here, Arun, Ujjal, and myself. Okay, so monogamy has also been used in different situations, as it is, as I have said, that it's a very important quantum key distribution, and in other physical scenarios, which I will also talk in the next slide. But it has been, for example, shown that the violation of Bell inequalities, for example, if you take correlation function Bell inequalities, and that is satisfy monogamy relation. Capacities of dense coding also satisfy monogamy relation. Fidelities of teleportation satisfy monogamy relation. Quantum steering also, there is some quantifier which also satisfy monogamy relation, but that's also, that's a bit more involved, that in which direction is satisfy and so on. There are many applications apart from quantum key distribution, the monogamy relation. One is, as I have already shown, that quantum discord family of generalized DHZ states satisfy monogamy relation. On the other hand, generalized W doesn't. So you can already get a hunch that it can be useful to detect certain kinds of states. So state discrimination, one can use monogamy relation. We have recently shown that it can be used also for channel discrimination, local channel discrimination. It's a lot of words where people have used monogamy inequality to detect quantum phases in quantum many-body systems. As I have told, that the monogamy inequality is best, it's a study or characterizations of multipartite property by using bipartite measures. And so it is easy, it is computable for certain states. And so it has been used, and it's also has been used to detect quantum phases in experiments. It has also been used in biological processes like photosynthesis. There are some recent work on quantum biological processes where also it has been used, this monogamy relation. Okay, so now I will introduce the concept that we have done recently, is activation of non-monogamous states. So I have 10 minutes, right? Okay, so the question that we ask is the following. So is there a way to make non-monogamous quantum correlation measures monogamous? Now, what are the way outs we know already? We know that if you consider quantum correlations with a suitable power, for example this, that you have a quantum correlation measure Q, and you take Q to the power A, then they may satisfy monogamy relation. And that we know from the experience of concurrence and negativity, as well as discord. That squared concurrence, squared negativity, squared discord, they all satisfy monogamy relation. Another way out is that if a certain quantum correlation measure violate monogamy relations, say for example for three party, we have shown in 2 years back that if you now consider the monogamy for a higher number of parties, then they may satisfy the monogamy relation. Now the question is, there is other way to think that? And so we ask this question. Given a bipartite quantum correlation measure, if a multiparty quantum state is non-monogamous with respect to that bipartite quantum correlation measure, is it possible to obtain monogamy when finite copy of the same state are available? So pictorially, this is like that. So the single copy level, it doesn't satisfy monogamy relation. Now you consider many copies of the same state shared between, say, three parties. And you write now the monogamy relations for this multipartite scenario. You want to ask whether there exists some finite M, M means number of copies, for which it satisfies the monogamy relation. This is in the similar spirit, we call the, this is activation, because there is a bound entangled state which was used to activate or to increase teleportation fidelity, or there is a inner state transformation. Another state was used to help the state transformation, which is known as catalysis. So in all this situation, this is called the activation. And here also we use that whether many copies can help to activate monogamy. And the answer that we find is yes. And we show that by using negativity as a measure that we have already defined. So before I show the activation, this result we have shown, and why is it important, I will tell you in a moment. So what we show that suppose a state, 3-qubit, tripartite state, satisfy monogamy relation, that means for negativity, that means it delta n is non-negative, then there exists m, or m copies of the same state also remain monogamy, that means also satisfy monogamy relation. Now the proof actually based on two things. One is we are able to write n rho 1 2 to the power m, that means m copies of rho 2 power, n copies of the bipartite state in that form, and the recursion relation. So induction or recursion method we use to prove this theorem. Now it is also possible to prove for n partite, which because you use induction, and so it's a bit more involved, but you just use theorem 1 to prove that. Now the activation. So now we consider that there is a 3-qubit mixed state which does not satisfy monogamy, means it violates. Then there exists always a m, positive integer m, such that the m copies of the state satisfy monogamy relation. Now, why the previous theorem is important? Because you never know. Suppose the single copy level, it is monogamous, and you write the m copies of the state, and you take the monogamy relation. Whether that do not go to, or that will not be negative, that we don't know before we prove that previous theorem. So, to prove activation, the initial previous theorem was required. And here also, the main ingredient that we use is that negativity, that means this one. This, I think this is the main crux where we are able to write negativity of the m copies of the bipartite state in that form. As you see, it's kind of 1 plus single copy to the power m. And that helped to prove all this theorem and the recursion relation. So this is not only for 3-qubit, we are able to prove for arbitrary number of qubits. To visualize this theorem, let's just look at this figure. Here we have plot, this is the histogram, for probability of obtaining delta n, this m copies of that, non-negative, against minimum number of copies required. So you see that the red ones are the GHZ class states. So we randomly generated hard uniformly states from the GHZ class. And the green ones are the states from W class. And what we find that among the GHZ class states, 88% non-monogamous states become monogamous if you take two copies of the state. So that's why this is so high. And there are only low peaks remaining. On the other hand, for the W class, the same is 47%. And you see that even the W class, although very probability is very low, but almost one requires 18 copies to make the some states monogamous. Now there is another scenario that we have considered, which is also kind of activation, or it's more like a what people have told catalysis in the context of quantum state transformation. So if you have a bipartite quantum correlation measure is given, which in our case negativity, and a multiparty quantum state is non-monogamous, is it possible to find another non-monogamous states which together satisfy the monogamy relation? So this is the mathematically how it looks. So negativity in with respect to rho is non-monogamous, so it violates monogamy. Sigma also violates monogamy relation. But together, can we have that these satisfy monogamy relation? So this is so you can take that sigma, whether sigma really likes a catalysis in the chemical process. So help to satisfy these monogamy relations for rho. Same is true for rho. And what we find for GHZ class, it is always possible to find some sigma, for which this is true. However, there are 1%, about 1% states from W class which do not satisfy monogamy relation, even with the help of another state. I am done. So another state can be chosen from the states from the GHZ class or from the W class. Even then, there are 1% states which does not satisfy monogamy relation. And since this is not universally true, we are unable to prove any theorem. As you notice that in the previous case, we have several theorems, but this one is not true for any arbitrary states. And so initially we thought we were close to the proof, but we realized that it's not possible because we did this numerical simulation and found that it is not true. So I come to the conclusion. So as I have already shown that the quantum correlation measures can be monogamous as well as non-monogamous. Now we introduce the concept of activation in the context of monogamy. We found that an arbitrary non-monogamous quantum state can satisfy monogamy relation when the finite number of copies of the same state is provided. We prove for the negativity. Now we also find that if there are two different 3-qubit pure non-monogamous states taken together, they can satisfy monogamy relation. It is true for all the states in the GHZ class, but not true for all the states in the W class. The above theorem is true for arbitrary number of parties in qubits. Here, this result is numerical, and so you see that we are only able to do for 3-qubit and not for higher number of parties because it's difficult to generate. Okay, so this is the QIC group at HRI, and we here actually 8 members from our group is present, so a lot of participation. And we also have QIPA 2018, which is the 5th in the row of QIPA in 2nd to 8th December 2018. So please check the website if you are interested to come to Allahabad. And thank you very much for your attention. Yes.
So if I understood you right, your conclusion, you use a particular measure of monogamy.
Yeah.
Is that something that can be addressed? Is there an optimal measure? And
one thing I should say that negativity has an advantage that it can be computable for arbitrary number of, arbitrary two-party state in higher dimension, as well as the negativity is can be computed for, say, mixed state A is to rest, this, which is not true for concurrence, because in concurrence, we can only calculate for 2-qubit state. This is the answer from the computability perspective. But of course, if we can, we are unable to prove, because as I said, that the key ingredient that we use in the proof is the sum property of negativity. That is the ingredient, apart from induction, which will be true for any other entanglement measure. But so I really don't know whether if Q is an, at least for arbitrary entanglement measure, whether we will be able to prove that.
Thank you.
You said that these monogamy relations work for some quantum correlation measures and don't work for some measures.
Yeah.
Is there a general classification or condition on the type of measure which can tell you which measure is good and which is bad, say based on some general property like Schmidt decomposition? Because you can always do Schmidt decomposition, it completely classifies, not characterizes the whole correlations.
Okay, so first of all, in case of pure states, when you talk about the Schmidt decomposition, then we know more, because all the measures that I show, they all reduce to the von Raman entropy of the local density matrices. So true for entanglement of formation, discord, not for logarithmic negativity. because it's a determinant of rho A, but at least the property, and you are absolutely right that you can write in terms of Smith decomposition. Now the good entanglement measure, information theoretic or the other measures independent of entanglement, I don't have answer. But in entanglement measure, there is a Longberg paper by Horodetsky's in 98 PRL paper, where they show that entanglement measures should satisfy certain conditions, then we can call them good entanglement measure. So some of the criteria are satisfied by the negativity, some are not. So this is the thing. So the two main point is was the first two point was LOCC monotone and it should be zero for all separable state. Negativity satisfied that. But there is also asymptotic continuity, convexity, that they don't, I think. Oh, Deepong. Yeah.
Postulates of entanglement measures. So just wanted to add that.
Yeah, that's
for,
true.
That they could do only for 3-qubit states. Then.
Yeah, yeah, that's for 3-qubit, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. Deepankar, yes.
So you mentioned that the result when taken 2 3-qubit states taken together in the mixed state. Of
yeah, yeah. So no, I want to define. No,
different?
No. Yeah, can be. Because I want to add that, I want to address that question. We are unable to answer that question.
No, no. So
because as I said that we want to address that whether given an arbitrary state rho, whether there is always possible to find another non-monogamous state sigma such that rho tensor sigma satisfy monogamy relation for arbitrary Q. This is a very general question we already asked. Even when we try to answer for negativity, we fail. As I said that for all GHZ class states satisfy, but W class doesn't. So then we restrict ourselves to pure state because we do numerical simulation and you know that if I go to higher number of qubits, it's not efficient. If I take the mixed state, only rank 2 can be efficient, so.
So the takeaway is that monogamous property cannot be, it's not a good measure of what is supposed to be good entanglement measure.
Okay, monogamy, that monogamy score that we define can be a multipartite measure, but it's not,
not
good
the,
in
not
a sense that it can be positive, negative, but it can be used in a different way, like positivity, negativity can be used for state discrimination, etc.
I think it's a very nice result, but I missed how you are distributing in the activation case, how you are distributing the systems. Are you increasing the number of parties or you're just distributing?
No, no, no.
Okay,
so we are not increasing. In the first case, I increase number of copies. So as
but
I
distributed
show,
to the same number of
parties. Same number of parties.
Thank you.
Thank you.